Hello all, welcome to ECVTV sectional program. This lecture is about thermal comfort indices and how to achieve thermal comfort, and various thermal indices or thermal scales that has been discovered by various scientists, physicists or climatologists to achieve thermal comfort, and how to measure this thermal comfort on different scales. To give an overview of this lecture, so first we are going to study about measuring indoor radiation, that is by globe thermometer. How to measure indoor radiation by globe thermometer, then indoor air movement, how to measure indoor air movement by Kata thermometer, then we'll try to understand what is corrected effective temperature. So in previous lecture we understood what is effective temperature, so in this lecture we are going to discuss corrected effective temperature and tropical summer index that is developed by CBRI Roorkee. Okay, so that is it's this comfort indices was developed in India. So usually other or you can say previous one were discovered by various other scientists throughout the world, but this was very much developed by Indians and applicable to tropical climate. Okay. So starting with measuring indoor radiation by globe thermometer. So what main measuring indoor radiation, so that is trying to understand the different types of radiation or different types of heat exchange that happens in an enclosed space. Now let us consider a room which may be having various other appliances, apparatus or different sources of heat, like window is also a source of heat if there is direct sunlight coming in. The roof slab is also a source of heat because of heat is radiated from the roof slab that is heated up because of the sunlight. Maybe the floor is also radiating heat. There might be heat exchange that is happening because of the convection currents that is flowing from the window or through the ventilator, or maybe different appliances will be radiating heat in the form of maybe conduction. So there might be some conduction also that is happening because of the physical contact of any of maybe earth or ground, or it can be because of the convection, that is because of the air movement that is happening, or because of the radiation from different appliances like laptops, computers, even fridge. They also generate some heat energy as they perform. So there might be many, even lighting systems, or it might be any other system, it might be music system or any other system, even TVs also generate a lot of heat. So to understand what is a, to analyze all these different types of heat and to achieve the mean temperature. Okay, so there might be, we might be gaining heat or we might be losing heat. So to achieve the mean, that is whatever the, considering the heat loss and heat gain in an enclosed space. Okay, so the human beings also radiate heat. Okay, so there might be some materials which will absorb heat. Okay, so try, so mean radiant temperature is nothing but trying to understand what is the mean temperature because of the gain or loss of heat in that particular indoor environment. So that temperature, which is what we get, what that recording what we get, is called as mean radiant temperature. So mean radiant temperature is average of all the temperature of from different sources that is in a particular, or you can say an enclosed space. Okay, so that temperature is called as mean radiant temperature. Now this mean radiant temperature is very much helpful to understand different thermal comfort indices, or you can say thermal comfort scales. Okay. instead of most of the time, instead of dry bulb temperature, we use this mean radiant temperature. Okay, now this as I say globe thermometer, we can see this image which shows, so this is the image of a globe thermometer. So it is having a copper globe which is approximately 15 centimeters of dia, and it is painted black. It is painted black because black is a very good conductor of heat compared to other white or any other colors, and it is made up of copper because copper is also a very good conductor of heat. So if there is any small change in the heat or heat gain or heat loss, so that can be sensed, or it is actually absorbed by this globe. Okay, now the thermometer which is kept in the center of this globe is again suspended in that particular enclosed space, because it should not be getting any heat from the, let's say, any floor or any other surfaces, or it might not be, it should not lose any heat. So we need to get a temperature which is in the enclosed space. So that is why we try to elevate it by either having different types of arrangement. As you can see on the left, there is a different type of arrangement as compared to the right one, which is having a tripod and this thing. So basically it is to suspend in the atmosphere in an ambient temperature or in an ambient condition. It should not be exposed to sunlight, because if it is exposed to sunlight, again, there might be a lot of heat gain that is happening because of the sunlight, incident sunlight on this globe. Okay, so there might be constant radiation of sunlight falling on this. So then that there might be a solar heat gain, and that might not show a correct recording or what the recording we wanted. Okay. So this gives a more precise value as compared to other thermometers. So this is considered as the best for the to understand what is a mean radiant temperature. Okay. So whatever the value we get, so when it is suspended, it is left for around 15 to 20 minutes so that it gets acclimatized, or it tries to absorb or heat loss, and it tries to reach an average at after 15, 20 minutes of it. It is placed in any environment. So after that, we try to get the reading, or maybe after sometimes after 20 minutes or 30 minutes, we get the proper reading. Okay. So that temperature, what we get, or the recording or the reading, what we get from this globe thermometer is also called as globe temperature or mean radiant temperature. So both the terminologies are used in practice. Okay. Now next comes the Carter thermometer. So the Carter thermometer is basically a device which is a thermometer which is may not be directly used to measure the temperature, but it is mainly used to measure the air movement. Okay, what is the air speed or air movement? So that we'll understand, we'll discuss in detail. So Carter thermometer is a device which is instead of mercury, the bulb is filled with alcohol thermometer. Okay, so it is basically having alcohol in the bulb of the thermometer. And alcohol is gives more precise, it is more volatile, and it expands more, and it is very sensitive towards the thermal change, or you can say temperature change, than compared to mercury. So for mercury to rise, it may take a larger temperature, but a small change or small variation in the temperature can be measured by using this alcohol thermometer. So that is why they try to use this Carter thermometer. Okay. Now this Carter thermometer has a readings which is called as Carter factor. So that we, I think we can understand by this Carter airspeed nomogram. Okay. So basically we can understand the air movement based on the heating of this alcohol thermometer, and also what is the cooling power or how much time it takes to cool this particular thermometer. So basically first step is to dip this thermometer into hot water. Okay, so when it is dipped into a hot water and it is wiped with a cloth, okay, so that it does not further influence the bulb, the water that is moisture present on the bulb should not further influence the readings of the thermometer. So the bulb is first dipped into the hot water and it is suspended inside a enclosed space where we want to measure the, let's say, air speed. Okay. So then what happens? The alcohol in the thermometer, as it is dipped as the thermometer is dipped into the hot water, the alcohol in the thermometer expands and it shows the highest value. Okay, whatever is the highest value. And when the bulb is wiped, okay, and then it starts cooling down. Okay, now the alcohol in the thermometer, as it is cooling down, it starts to decline, or it starts to come down. Okay. Now there is some time that is taken for the alcohol or the reading from the highest toward to the whatever the room temperature is. Okay. So if the room temperature is, let's say, 30 degrees or 20 degrees or 25 degrees, so even the alcohol in the thermometer try to achieve that particular temperature, because as per laws of thermal equilibrium, as per laws of thermodynamics, the heat energy always try to maintain equilibrium. So similarly, even the alcohol in the thermometer, it tries to achieve equilibrium with the surrounding nature. So it tries to achieve equilibrium whatever the temperature of the room is. So then it will show the reading on the, so then we can make out how much time it is taken for the alcohol thermometer to show this from the highest towards the to the current situation. Okay, so let's say highest is 600 Kata factor. So as we dip the bulb into the Kata thermometer, so it will rise up to 600, and based on the temperature, whatever the temperature, like let's say if it is 30 degrees or 35 degrees, so it will try to achieve that particular temperature. Okay, so now there is some time that is taken based on the wind speed. Yes, if the wind speed is more, then the thermometer will get cooled down faster. If the wind speed is less, then the thermometer will cool down slower. So this is, I think, a basic principle that has been used in devising this particular Kata thermometer. Okay, so based on the wind speed, so it also behaves, or it cools down based on the wind speed. So similarly, it takes different time based on the wind speed, whether it is faster or slower. So it gives three values, you can say. One is the Kata factor, that is what is the value that has been, what is the temperature that change happened, and also what is the cooling time that is taken, and what is the temperature that is it is presented. Okay, so using these three values, we can basically calculate, we can actually calculate the you can say wind speed. So that is why it is called as Kata airspeed nomogram. Now this nomogram, as you can see on the left, it is a Kata factor, the vertical, and an inclined, so that is again showing the cooling time, how much time it take to cool this liquid inside the thermometer. So did it take 10 seconds, 20 seconds? So this is in the time of in the this thing of seconds, in the unit is seconds. Here again, the vertical, that is nothing but cooling power. Okay, so that we'll understand what is the cooling power of the particular environment. Okay, so and also which is inclined again, let's say towards this thing. So we can see temperature, which is again showing 0 degrees, 10 degrees, 20 degrees Celsius. So this again is, this is nothing but you can say either it is dry bulb temperature, or it is globe temperature, or you can say mean radiant temperature. Okay, so it is either called as mean radiant temperature or globe temperature also. So So this we need to also measure these things. What is the globe temperature? Because of which we can easily find out what is the air speed. Okay. Now we use this Kata thermometer to find out air speed, because the wind anemometer is good for outdoor air movement, where there is more air and there is enough pressure to push the cup cone anemometer to find out the air movement. But whereas indoor spaces have very slow air movement or very less air movement, which is very difficult to find out by anemometer. Okay, so that is why we try to find out this with a, because there is a very small, or you can say the wind, so sometimes it is around 0.001 meter per second, or 0.5 meter per second, okay, or maybe 1 or 2 meter per second. So which is very difficult for you to calculate this wind speed, very small, or this thing, very precise speed by using different equipments. So this is the ideal equipment to understand the wind speed within an enclosed space or an indoor space. Okay, so this may not be used for outdoor spaces. Okay, so first we got the Kata value, that is the Kata factor. So we have marked 400, so it reached to a minimum of 400, so it is not reaching more than 400. So we'll mark this 400 on the Kata airspeed nomogram. So then we get the cooling time, how much time it take from 600 to reach for the alcohol to reach from 600 to 400. So that is again let's say 25 seconds approximately. So then we draw a line from 400 to, so this 25 seconds on, that is on the inclined scale. Okay. So then we further extend it to find out what is the cooling power. So here we can find out what is the cooling power. So here it is around 10, 15. So it is between 10 and 20. It is very close to 15, and it is 16. Okay. So 16, that is nothing but again the cooling power of that particular environment. Okay. Now we have already know what is the temperature, that is mean radiant temperature or dry bulb temperature, so that we can mark dry bulb temperature if it is around, let's say, 25 degrees Celsius. Okay. So it is between 20 and 30. So we presume that it is, let's say, 25. We take an example of 25 degrees. So we, from this point where we reach the cooling power because of the cutoff factor and cooling time, that is further extended to this vertical line. So from here cooling power, we try to draw a line that is crossing the temperature and reaching to the airspeed line. Okay. So we draw a straight line and try to find out what is the airspeed. Now the blue dot what we see is nothing but, again, it is in between 1 and 2, approximately it is 1.5 meter per second. Okay. So based on the cooling factor, that is nothing but again cutoff factor, cooling factor, cooling time, and the present existing temperature, we can easily find out what is the airspeed. So this is about finding the airspeed by our indoor air movement by using Kata thermometer. Okay. So here you can say the airspeed is 1.5 meter per second. Okay. Now most of these comfort scales, what we initially studied was let's say effective temperature. So that does not consider the air movement. Okay. So that is why they reintroduced it as corrected effective temperature, in which they considered air movement. Okay. So this was the device which was used to understand, or you can say calculate, what is the exact airspeed or air movement. And by using globe thermometer, we can understand what is the precise mean radiant temperature and get a exact value of what is the exact mean radiant temperature, because of which we can easily find out both, that is temperature and air movement. Okay. So then we can easily understand what is effective temperature, or what is a, how to achieve thermal comfort. Okay, based on the measurement of existing values. Okay. Now CLOW value is nothing but the clothing value. So based on the thickness, so here you can see it is, he is half naked or half dressed and very thin clothes, so then it is considered as 0.5, 0.6 or 1.2 for a medium dressed. And if it is color, it is darker color with a, again, he is trying to wear something inside the suit or blazer. So again, it is increasing the insulation. So as the insulation increases or thickness increases, we can say the CLOW value also increases. So based on, you can easily classify different climates in India, climatic zones in India having different dressing cultures. Okay, so that were developed based on the climatic conditions of that particular environment. Like if you go to Kerala, where it is very hot and humid and this thing, so the cultural dressing is very much different. Or even the dressing is, they try to use lower U values in hot and humid or hot and dry areas. If you go to very cold places like Himalayas or Mount Abu, or very cold places in Assam, so there they use clothes with higher CLOW value because they want insulation, they want to protect from heat. Okay. Now this also influences, as we studied earlier, this also influences the comfort, you can say thermal comfort of particular region or particular person. Okay, so different person having different metabolic rate and performing different activity and different body mass and these things. So there will be different thermal comfort. Okay, but we need to understand what is that person wearing, so that we can easily calculate, or what are the people wearing, like if it is an office area, if it is a school, if it is house, or if it is any gym. So what are the people wearing, and what, based on the activity, we can also calculate what is a thermal comfort that has to be achieved to that particular area. Okay. So corrected effective temperature is nothing but it induces or influences, it also considers the influence of air movement. Okay. Now, first what we studied was the graph of effective temperature. So now this is a nomogram that was generated for corrected effective temperature. So this is having again two vertical lines that are, you can say, dry bulb temperature or globe thermometer, globe temperature. You can see on the left, In the ascending order, so from the bottom, you can say 0 to 45 degrees Celsius. That is nothing but dry bulb temperature or wet bulb or globe temperature that is measured by globe thermometer, or you can also say mean radiant temperature. And WBT is nothing but wet bulb temperature. So that is again also marked from 0 to 45 degrees. So for understanding this, how to mark or how to use this corrected wet temperature, we have marked 30 degrees Celsius as the reading on the globe thermometer. And usually the wet bulb temperature is lower because of it is having high humidity. So this is not considering the humidity. This is having a high relative humidity. So then you can say the wet bulb temperature is around 25 degrees Celsius. Okay. So we try to mark, to try to understand how to measure the corrected effective temperature for any area by using this nomogram. Okay. So we have marked in the red, that is 30 degrees Celsius, that is globe temperature, and 25 degrees Celsius as wet bulb temperature. So in next step, we join these two lines and we cut across these lines, these many lines, curved lines, and these lines. So these basically indicates these along the this thing. So they indicate the airspeed. Okay. So we can see zero. Okay. Here we can see 0.5 meter per second, 1 meter per second, 1.5 meter per second, 2 meter, and up to 7 meter per second. So this is the highest. So that is the airspeed of 7 meter per second. And these lines, which are running again perpendicular to the, almost perpendicular to the curve lines, which are perpendicular to the airspeed, are nothing but again corrected effective temperature or effective temperature. So these show what is the effective temperature because of the particular, you can say, wind speed or air velocity. So then, so based on the, if we calculate what is the airspeed for a particular area, so here we can say it is 25, sorry, the temperature is 25, but you can say the airspeed here is around 2 meter per second. Okay, so if you consider this curve, that is 2 meter per second is the air movement in that particular area. So we know the temperature, we know the air movement. So then we can understand what is the effective temperature. So how a human being feels, okay, in that particular place by using, so this is a nomogram that is developed for a flow value of 1. If a person is wearing a very thin clothes or a normal clothing, so he might feel that it is 25 degrees Celsius. Okay. So if we try to reduce the, so this what is marked, you can say slightly, which is more gray. So that is nothing but again a comfort zone. So that is based on the, we can say we can do many surveys based on the different people. Okay. So if you take, let's say, 100 samples or 1000 samples, then we can understand what is the majority people feeling comfortable in which temperature and which air movement and which humidity. So based on that, we can say this is a comfortable zone, or you can say thermal comfort for the majority of the population. So based on this, we can say this is a comfort zone for a majority of people. So and also we can see that if I try to increase airspeed, so it is going towards a non-comfort or discomfort. If I'm trying to reduce the airspeed, it is achieving comfort zone. Yes. So here we can see in this 25 degrees Celsius also. So to reduce temperature, what we have to reduce the, you can say, airspeed also. Okay. So usually it is, this is representing the effective temperature of that particular area. Okay. So this is how we can calculate what is a corrected effective temperature for different areas. Okay. Now coming to tropical summer index, as the name itself indicates, so it is usually meant for the very tropical, or we can say tropical climates. Okay. So a tropical summer index is by using three values, that is again wet bulb temperature, globe temperature, and air velocity. So this gives a precise value. It is just by using calculation. A simple equation, you can say, so in which tropical summer index is equal to 0.308 into wet bulb temperature, so TW is wet bulb temperature, plus 0.745 into TG is nothing but globe temperature, or globe mean radiant temperature also you can say, minus 2.06 into the square root of the air velocity. Okay, so whatever is a V is nothing but air velocity plus 0.841. So this is the equation for that as developed by CBI Roorkee to understand what is tropical summer index, or so this is actually a tropical index to understand what is the effective temperature in the tropical climate. Okay, now we all know that the coefficient that is 0.308, so this is precisely you can say 30% of you can say wet bulb temperature, and precisely so this is again 74% of or 70% of so this is 30% of these things, so 70% of the wet bulb or you can say globe temperature, which is again we try to so usually the air is cooled because of this thing, so that is why we try to minus or subtract that is the air velocity into this constant to get the precise value. Okay, so this equation, if you consider one example of this where let's say wet bulb temperature is around 23 degrees and globe temperature is around 30 degrees and air velocity let's say it is 1 meter per second, so if you try to put the values in this particular equation, yes, where tropical summer index is equal to 0.308 into wet bulb temperature plus 0.745 into globe temperature or mean radiant temperature minus 2.06 into square root of air velocity plus 0.841. Okay, so this gives the value that is around 28.21, which is again slightly which is very close to the globe temperature. Okay, you can see the 28.121 is again effective temperature that is calculated by using tropical summer index. Okay, so this gives a value which is again majorly for the tropical climates. Okay, so this is again tropical summer index that is plotted on a psychrometric chart. Psychrometric chart, what we discussed in the previous lecture, where these vertical lines indicate the dry bulb temperature, and these curved lines indicates the relative humidity, and these inclined lines indicate the wet bulb temperature. Okay, or if you can also say this is saturation point where there is 100% humidity along the top curve, and the lowest curve is again 0% humidity, and that is why it is showing dry bulb temperature. Okay, so here they have marked a slightly you can say range that is based on the humidity and the temperature. So based on the surveys that was done, so you can say there are three thermal sensations, slightly cool, which is again in blue, so that if people feel slightly cool, so these three you can say are thermal comfort. So these are mainly thermal comfort, but this is which is in blue, that is around 19 degrees to 25 degrees people feel it is slightly cool. Okay, and comfortable at 25 to 30. It is also 22 to 27, which is considered as ideal, which is considered as the best thermal comfort, and slightly warm, that is more than 30 to 30, approximately you can say 34 degrees Celsius. So they feel slightly warm as compared to other temperature zones. Okay, so this also gets influenced because of the acclimatization. If a person is acclimatized to let's say cold climate, then he feels 30 or 34 degrees very warm. Okay, if a person is acclimatized to let's say 30 or 34 degrees, then he feels it very cold. Okay, and a person, whoever, if it is, is from the colder region or from the hotter region, he might consider, he might get easily get acclimatized to this thermal comfort, which is around 25 to 30 degrees Celsius. Okay, and the relative humidity also is around 30 to 70%, it is not more than that. Okay, so 30 to 70% of humidity is considered as best for all the climatic zones, and also the temperature you can say the whole range what you can say is from 19 degrees to maximum of 34 degrees. So we can divide this into three segments, slightly warm or comfort, and then slightly cold. Okay, so that has been marked in this you can say psychometric chart. Now based on, if I am locating, if I am trying to locate my existing let's say current temperature or humidity, if I am reaching somewhere here, so let's say I am having 35 degrees Celsius and I am having humidity of let's say 20% or 30%, so by just increasing humidity I can achieve thermal comfort, or by reducing temperature by various ways, by inducing passive ventilation or increasing the air movement, what we can see, we saw in the corrected effective temperature. By various ways, we can achieve thermal comfort. So how to achieve thermal comfort will be understood in the further lecture. So this is basically to give understanding about what is a human thermal comfort and what are the different index, or you can say indices, or comfort scale that has been developed for the climatology, okay, to understand the temperatures and how we can achieve thermal comfort by either humidifying, dehumidifying, or by increasing or reducing the wind speed, or by increasing or reducing let's say temperatures. Okay, so there are various ways to achieve this particularly thermal comfort. There are various passive ways in which we don't have to depend on mechanical modes or mechanical devices or appliances. Okay, so those things we'll study in detail. So this is all for the tropical summer index. This is all for the thermal comfort. Okay, and thermal comfort indices. Okay, thank you.